Hi guys, welcome to this video, in which you are going to answer a simple question about computer. And the question is, how heck does it work? Before electronics, children and guys were able to build their own toys, or at least to understand how they work. Nowadays, the toy is often a video game, and we really don't know what there is inside and in which way it is able to be so great. This is true even for adults, often working with a machine they don't know nothing about. So, if you are ready, let's go started. We can start thinking about our use of the computer. We write and read through it. We watch video or movies. And we definitely play with it. What is there inside the computer? Pictures? Letters? Numbers or books? Not at all, none of these things. Inside a computer there is just a single thing. Bits, a lot of bits, a sea of bits, but just that. Actually there is nothing else. Now the problem is, what is a bit? A bit is something with just two states, head or tail, on and off of a light bulb, or dash and dot of the telegraph. Actually, the telegraph is a good example, because we had a little step. Indeed, dash and dots are organized to code every character and punctuation of the alphabet. In this way, we can transmit messages. Note how you put dash and dots side by side to saving more digits for a character. Another example of bit is a circuit with a switch that can be open or closed. So, with two states. We use a common electromechanical switch that has, unfortunately, a big problem. It is very, very slow. In our case, for a computer, a bit is a voltage which can have two states. For example, 3 volt and 0 volt, or 1 and 0, if you prefer. And in order to pass from a state to the other, we use an electronic switch called transistor. As you can see, if I apply 0 volt to point G, the transistor is off and the circuit is open. If I apply 3 volt to point G, the transistor is on and the circuit is closed. Furthermore, the transistor has very important features. It is very small and it is very fast. So, until now, we learned that a computer is a machine that manages bits and it is very fast. Or, more precisely, that a computer Earth is made by very small devices which can only have two states, but that can switch very fast from one to the other. But now the problem is, what you can do with bits? So now we can ask ourselves, what can we do with bits? Well, using multiple digits, I can encode characters. We saw something similar with the telegraph, but in this case we use 0-1 instead of dash and dots. We see the ASCII code used to encode characters, letter, number, punctuation. You see we use 8 bits, so 8 digits, which is called a byte. Another thing you can do with bits is managing pictures. You can divide a picture in tiny little square and represent the color of the little square with its own 3 primary colors. Red, blue and green, each one with a gradation represented by 8 bits. So, with different gradation mix of the primary colors, you can represent every shade. So, for example, the white is represented by 8 ones for the red, 8 for the green and 8 for the blue. You can memorize the whole picture storing these 3 byte for every pixel. With bits, of course, I can count 0, 1 and 2. You can see I just need to add more digits. 3, 4 and 5 and so on. And we can do all the math with bits, because it is just another counting system. It is called binary system, and we can do all kind of operation we do with decimal system. We are used to the decimal system, But dealing with two states is easier for computers, because we can use a lot of small transistors in order to switch very fast between the two states, 0 and 1. So with bits you can represent everything by encoding. For example, the byte 00110010 can represent the letter Q in ASCII code, or can be the number 50, or can be a certain gradation of the color red, for example. So, who decides which is the bit meaning? Simple. Application. Software. They are created for a specific purpose and a specific need. So, here it is an important finding. Computer doesn't know the meaning behind the bits. That's why we need different softwares, because each one has its own interpretation and purpose. What we have learned so far? First, with bits, you can represent everything by encoding, and we can do all the math using a binary system. Second, we can implement this two-state system in a very efficient way with transistors, very small and very fast. Third, a computer is a general-purpose machine that can do many things as long as it has its own specific applications in order to interpret the meaning behind bits. Let's think about the third point. This means the software enables the computer to be a game machine, a web browser, a word processor, and perform a wide range of functions. So what is an application or a software? Basically, it's a set of instructions written in a language similar to human language. But computer understands and manages just bits, so it has to be translated in a machine language with just 0 and 1s. These are the executable files, which probably you heard something about. Let's forget bits for a while. Let's focus on the general purpose machine, which can read and execute set of instructions. We can divide this process in four steps. An input phase, in which computer acquires data. Later, it stores the data and processes them, providing an output. This cycle characterizes every general purpose machine. The architecture complying with our cycle and our general purpose machine is the von Neumann architecture. It is composed by an arithmetic and a logic unit which executes instruction provided by the memory, and it is controlled by a control unit. The executable instructions are provided by some software called by the mouse or by the keyboards, which are our inputs. And we can see the results on the screen, or we can print it, and these are our outputs. The control unit and the ALU, and in some extent even the memory, make up the CPU, or central processing unit. So, what have we learned so far? First, computer is a general purpose machine which executes set of instructions. Second, we use the von Neumann architecture, in which we have an arithmetic and logic unit controlled by a control unit in order to execute instructions provided by a memory unit. So, which are next questions? Now the problem is understanding how a computer reads and executes instruction. So, how a CPU work? And how does a memory work? How can we provide inputs? So, how do keyboards and mouse work? And how computer provide outputs? So, how screens work? Too many questions for just one video. This video wants to be just an introduction. So we'll start answering this question in the next one. Please leave me a comment and let me know if you liked this video. Make sure you put the thumb up, click the notification bell, and please subscribe to my channel so I can produce more videos. Bye bye!